Welcome back to my channel Math School. In today's video, let us solve example 5 from chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry. In my previous videos, I have completed the examples 1 to 5 and Introduction to Trigonometry video. If you have not watched that video, do find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. And do subscribe to my channel and hit the bell button so you will get the latest updates of my videos. Now quickly, let us begin with the video. Example 5 from chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry says, in triangle OPQ, right angled at P, OP is equal to 7 centimeters and OQ minus PQ is equal to 1 centimeter. Determine the value of sine Q and cos Q. So here Q is our acute angle where we have to find out the value of sine Q and cos Q given OPQ is a right angle triangle, right angle at P, and they have given us the value of PQ and OQ minus PQ as equal to 1 centimeter, right? So let us write down what is given in the question first. In triangle OPQ, OP is equal to 7 centimeters and OQ minus PQ is equal to 1 centimeter. From what is given, let us write down here, so let us send this PQ to right hand side. So OQ will be equal to 1 plus PQ. So let this be equation number 1. Now let us apply the Pythagoras theorem to right angle triangle OPQ so that we can find out all the three sides value. So by Pythagoras theorem, it is given by hypotenuse square is equal to the base square plus the perpendicular square. Here our hypotenuse is OQ, since it is opposite the right angle triangle, and OP is our perpendicular as it is opposite the acute angle Q, and QP is the base here. So let us substitute. What is hypotenuse? It is OQ square is equal to OP square plus a perpendicular is PQ square. So we don't know the value of OQ square. So OQ square is equal to, what is OP square value? It is 7 square plus PQ square. We also don't know the value of PQ square. We are writing as it is. Here, instead of OQ square, we can write 1 plus PQ from equation 1. So from 1, we can write 1 plus PQ the whole square as equal to 7 square plus PQ square. So from this, we can find out the value of PQ. 1 plus PQ the whole square is of the form A plus B the whole square. So what is the formula for this? It is A square plus 2AB plus B square, right? So let us apply the formula here. Since the value of 1 is A, so it is 1 square plus 2AB, that will be 2PQ, plus B square will be PQ square equal to 7 square plus PQ square. So PQ square on left hand side and right hand side can be cancelled. So we will be left with, what is 1 square is 1 plus 2PQ equal to, what is 7 square is 49. So let us send this 1 to right hand side. So we will get 2PQ is equal to 49 minus 1, or 2PQ is 49 minus 1 is 48, or PQ is equal to 48 by 2. So therefore PQ will be equal to 1 times 2 2s are 4, 2 4s are 8. PQ value is equal to 24 centimeter. Now we know the value of PQ. Let us substitute this PQ value in equation 1 so that we can get the OQ value. So OQ is what? 1 plus PQ. So OQ is 1 plus PQ value, that is 24. Therefore OQ will be equal to 25 centimeters. Now we know all the three sides, that is OQ is 25, hypotenuse 25, PQ is 24 and OP is 7 centimeters. Now we can find out the values of sine Q and cos Q. Now what are the trigonometric ratios? How do we, the simplest method to remember the trigonometric ratio is, remember this ratio, that is PBP by HHB. So what is sine Q? Sine Q is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse. This is the sine value and this is the cos value. So here perpendicular is what? Perpendicular value is equal to 7 centimeters by hypotenuse is 25 centimeters. So sine Q value is 7 by 25. Similarly, let us find out the cos q value. Trigonometric ratio for cos is base by hypotenuse. So here base is 24 centimeter and hypotenuse is 25. So therefore cos q is equal to 24 by 25. So this is how we determine sin q and cos q value. If you have any further doubts, you can comment me below in the comment section. In my next video, I'll be solving question number 1 from exercise 11.1, chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry. So till then, do like my video, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos, as I'll be completing the whole syllabus for class 10th SLC NSERT Math. And also do watch the related videos of chapter 11, Introduction to Trigonometry, shown on the screen. Thank you.